3D modeling is a great way to do space planning for either exhibitions, events, or any other way you may need to have a 3D model of an interior space. It's best to use multiple sources of information to create a 3D space. You can use a floor plan, actual measurements from the space, and photos. This is a model of a 3D space that I made from floor plans and actual measurements. Now I want to double check that everything is right and set up some nice views of photographs for some composites. I can match my photographs in Blender using the perspective matching tool of fSpy. Here in fSpy, I've lined up the perspective lines for this photo. If I turn off dimming, here you can see the photo has the same door and it's the room that I modeled. I put the origin point here in the corner and I've lined up all the lines. Once I save this file, I can import it into Blender. In Blender, I have my origin point at the same spot as the fSpy photo. File, import fSpy. If you don't see the option to import fSpy, you need to install the fSpy import Blender add-on. I have a link in the description showing you how to do that. Navigate to where the fSpy file is saved and then import it. As you can see, the room is now the wrong size as seen from the fSpy camera. What we want to do is make sure that we don't scale the actual room because then it throws out all the work we did matching real-world dimensions to our model. We need to scale the camera. But if we just scale the camera, that also doesn't work because it's lined up with the image. The important thing to do before scaling the fSpy camera in Blender is to move from the median point to the 3D cursor. Now if I scale looking through the fSpy camera, it's going to scale the relationship of the camera to the 3D cursor and leave the model the same size. Here I can press S and notice that the model seems to get bigger, but it's really the same size. The model hasn't changed size, just the fSpy camera. If I zoom out, here is the fSpy camera. I can tell that it's looking the wrong way, so I want to make sure that the fSpy camera is looking this way like it is in the photograph. I can rotate the fSpy camera as long as I'm rotating it from the median point. So if I press R, Z, negative 90, now I can see that the fSpy camera is in the correct spot for my photograph. If I jump back into the fSpy camera by toggling camera view, I can't see anything. So what should I do? I can click on the fSpy camera, then down here in the camera settings, scroll down to background image. If you have to, you can twirl it out. Then under the background image, make sure it's in front, and then at approximately 50% opacity. Now I can see both the room, photo, and my model. Still selecting the fSpy camera and making sure that we are scaling from the 3D cursor, press S, and now I can scale until I can see inside the room. Now you can see that this is very close because I can see the door and the wall. I want to make sure that I scale to the right size. And before even doing that, I may want to zoom in and make sure the camera is lined up because a 3D model is a perfect situation and it may not be exactly correct to the room. So now if I press G, Y, I can move the fSpy camera like this. And then I can press G, Z and make sure I kind of move it to where it needs to be for the height. This is just approximate, and I think that's pretty close. Now I'll zoom out my view, still with the fSpy camera selected, press S, and you cannot scale just one direction. You have to scale all directions at the same time. I'll press scale and bring this down a bit until that door starts to match. I'm gonna zoom in, press S, and I think this is pretty good. You can see that the door frame is matching. This door is ajar slightly and my doors in the model are closed, but you can see the handle is in approximately the right space. And if I look, I can see this column from the 3D model approximately in the right space it would be in real life. And another nice double checkpoint is the ceiling. You can see the ceiling is very close to the right size right there. Now we can start to decide which things are more accurate, the photo or our measurements. Either could be wrong. Another good way to check that you're correct is to orbit back out and just reality check. Was this where I was standing when I took the photo? Yes, I was standing in this back corner looking this direction. If you notice that the camera is on the floor or the camera is way outside, then you know that this is not where that photo match is. I'm going to zoom back in on fSpy. Notice that there's no light switches modeled here. I didn't take any measurements of the light switches. and I may want to use those or know where they are. By using this photo match and my 3D model, I can create something pretty accurate and approximate. The important thing is instead of using the 3D cursor now, I want to move to the median point. I can press Shift A, add a new mesh. Let's say let's add a cube. Here's a large cube. I can select that cube and scale it down. Now it's scaling around the median point. I can scale it in the X and Y direction by pressing SX and then SY and then SZ just to get it close to the right size. Now I can press GY, move it over, and then GZ. First, I'll orbit around. Here you can see that the light switch, although the wrong size, is in the correct place. If I'm looking through the camera and I accidentally have it on 3D cursor in Blender and I press S and I scale this object, it's getting smaller. GY, move it over, and then GZ, move it up, and I'm getting close. I might orbit to check. I can scale it down a bit more. GY, scale it a bit more. And then I can orbit around to make sure it's in the right spot. Because this was right on the actual wall and axes, it was pretty easy to move into space in the correct spot. Always double check where everything is, and remember to make sure you choose between scaling between the 3D cursor when you're scaling the camera, and then the actual object using the median point to position it, and double check with your model. You can also add multiple fSpy cameras to have more views of your interior scene. Hopefully this helps you scale an fSpy camera in Blender to match a real-world scale model that you're working on for your installation or project. Happy 3D modeling.